plăcere să-l invit acum pentru încheierea acestei sesiuni plenare a doua a conferinței Share București 2020 pe arhitectul Bogdan Babici, vă rog, și voi trece și în limba engleză for the introduction of our colleague Bogdan Babici, founder at the TECON Architecture Office. He graduated at the Ion Mincu Institute of Architecture and had a master's degree later on. He's a member of the Romanian Order of Architects. And between the years of 2000 and 2001, he specialized in the architecture and design studio Cesar Pelli and Associates in New York. He collaborated with the architecture firms Penta Design and Artline. And since 2000, he's sole partner of TECON. Among the remarkable and notable works that bear his signature are residential buildings, villas and collective housing, social facilities, educational projects, gyms, swimming pools, sports facilities, as well as shops, pensions, and hotels. Bogdan Babici is one of the most talented representatives of the young generation, noted on the occasion of architectural competitions, annuals, biennials, and frequent winner of nominated, awarded, and highlighted. Thank you for being with us today, physically in Bucharest, and the floor is yours.
Thank you for inviting me here. I will try to make a short presentation. I decide to show you some small steps that we make it in a path of last 20 years, when we start to realize that infrastructure built today determines tomorrow burdens. So I start like a young architect to understand the very important role of sustainability and go on this way to convince all our clients from that time that a sustainable approach means add value in their buildings. Sustainability can only achieved in a common effort, working with working together like a target, considering the common future and natural resources limitation, energetical and economical efficiency. Now, I'll try also to manage this. Eco-friendly building design and regulation become a major consideration for area with advanced urbanization and continue growing and densification process. So how to achieve building envelope sustainability with maintaining a good balance between environmental and social economic factors, because affordability, it's linked with the region, with the geographical and culture and the economical capacity of a city. So when I think about sustainability, I take in consideration the recyclability and reducing the waste during the construction. And of course, this way it's the way that we also can perpetuate local culture and identity. Energy saving, minimize, control energy loads and losses. Transformability, flexibility buildings according to the future needs. And of course, reduce the CO2 emission and minimizing carbon footprint. And at the end, the urban responsibility and generation the quality of life. So as I told you, I will show you some bits from our last decade path. This was our first experiment almost 20 years ago. It was a building that we decided to erect it together with some friends with a very, very small amount of money at that moment. So we were forced, without knowing too many about the sustainability at that moment, we were forced to think about recycling parts of old and industrial building to decrease the cost of the investments. In that way, at that moment, we bring their steel structure and facade panels that we recycle from an old industrial site that we covered with these meshes of stainless steel, also some refurbished material from industrial machinery. So we put it together, we consider in a creative way to generate this mesh and this texture of the facade that collaborate together and to increase the thermoisolation capacity of the facade, we use also recycled flux paper, 20 centimeters, in idea to obtain at that moment the lower cost of the building. After this, of course, the building were appreciated at won some price at that moment, and we are proud that in this moment, being an insertion in a old city park, it's still removable from there. And if somebody decide to remove the building, the all the not all 60-70% of the components of the building can be also recycled. Next project, it's about public infrastructure, didactic swimming pools, and that we will present, because here it was our first victory in collaboration with authorities to convince them to have an approach about sustainability, to use woods like a main material that fix the carbon, and to generate a sustainable building at affordable price, being public money. So in this off-site fabrication elements, because we bring the lamellar wood arches from a neighbor factory, we put prefabricated panels together, insulation and interior finishing, phono absorption, and this in the big size become the support for outside skin, where we use sinusoidal sheet metal that offer to this building also a good ventilation because of the profile of the sinus and because of the shape of the roof, let the air flow. And this decrease the loads of heating during the very hot summer here in Romania. And of course, being very well isolated, the building have a very good cost in exploitation period. Also, nowadays, a lot of old buildings somehow close their period of life, and we have option to demolish them or to think in a sustainable way to recover and refurbish what it can be refurbished and give a new life and put a new activity inside of the building. This is the case of a building of a Faculty of Horticulture and Landscaping Design in Bucharest, where they have this old building and built it in the 50s, where we decide to preserve this existing outside wall with the decoration, like an idea to keep the identity that building have in this moment and to transform it in a way to obtain an image according with the identity of the faculty. We talk about horticulture and landscaping design, people that are there to study plants and things about agriculture. So we choose to remodelate the roof like a present intervention of us. And for consolidation, we keep the actual facade using the traditional technique to refurbish and put the consolidation inside. And also we increase the thermal isolation with the layer also inside of the building with multiple bricks. Going on the top of the building, we try to offer space, not just to respond to the real function of the building, but also to create a space for communities, for students to convince them to spend more time in a university together socializing than just going to courses. And that's why we try to organize this upper part of the building like a small village, taking this iconic shape at the volume of and the scale of the volume common with the scale of the houses and the roof in the very close neighborhood of the building. Each volume represents of a very sincere and inside space defined by study area, offices for conductors and professors, space for media tech and library, amphitheater, and of course, place for socialization, where we let we generate a cafeteria and with a shade under the shady and protected space to convince the students to come there and stay together and generate links for all their life. So, of course, from the facade point of view, as I told you, the refurbishing of the old facade, we try to keep the image and we come with the traditional technologies, but in the upper part, also we want to implement sustainable principles in idea to use recyclable materials, everything prefabricated and bringing there and lowerized the time of construction in idea to obtain a much more affordable price at the end of the investments. So third object, it's also rehabilitation. It's a ice hockey arena in somewhere in the central part of the country, a building of also in the 50s with a nice history. It's not from the beginning ice hockey arena, but after he organized like an ice hockey arena, it appears problem because of the humidity on the very aggressive inside atmosphere without be controlling the ventilation and so on. All these things we discovered after we start to go forward in this project. So going forward, we try to recover and to keep this building like an ice hockey because it's in the constant of the of the community there. Here is a place where a lot of young people and families come here and stay together playing hockey, playing football. So it's a place for Georgian city where community choose to meet each other, especially that in this part we have also didactic swimming pool that is erected in this moment and also other sport facilities. So of course we were forced to keep part of the structure, wood lamellar structure, and to change with the new one, but keeping the same concept of using this wood material and this eco-friendly technologies, and we conserve the section over the arena, but we must enlarge the building because we should make place for circulation and to transform this small ice skating in a something more proper for nowadays needs. Also a place where the community meets there after the training of the local teams, and this building become multifunctional. We bring here restaurants, cafeteria, shops, and also the old arena we propose to be multifunctional, implementing some technology that can isolate the ice and transform all this ring with removing the margins of the ice area, becoming a place where you can organize local events, concerts, and this kind of things that brings people together. So also in the outside, because we already tested this system and didactic swimming pool with a sinusoidal plate, steel plate, we observed the efficiency of this ventilated facade with a very, very affordable price. We propose the same thing here. So we cover, we will use the same prefabricated large size panels that come together, interior finishing and isolation and support for outside layer. This is another project, another step on our ways. It happened almost 10 years ago or 8. It was a building that at that moment we convinced the client to make, we named it eco-friendly at that moment, eco house, because it's completely independent energetically. So they build drills in the hole to use a warm pump for heating and cooling, and the facade it's near zero isolated. But why I bring it here, because of this connection with the urban space, where we put this filtration layer between private inside window, the glass that connect and let make a filtration between let's say private area and public area. And also we want to send this message to use more this kind of green climbing plants that also can make a very affordable sun shading, filtration and privacy, but also the most important thing is that they fix the carbon and help us to, if they come in a big big surfaces, help us to improve the environmental quality. So this is another small villa where we try to avoid to go in direction of having a facade. So here it's a combination, a composition of volume, with very low, let's say low tech with a very simple facade that combine together with structure that is exposed and generate the image and the identity of a house that is in a very hilly plot where we didn't want to cut the connection between public street that it's in the front of the city and the backyard, and like we designed this like a path. You go and we can pass in these spaces of this building and have a different view and a very good connection from outside to inside. Of course, on this bridge is the living room where it's with the glass a little bit behind to be shaded during the summer, and with very nice light during the winter. So in the white volumes, we have a dormitory, and in the middle on the bridge, we have the place where all the family come together and offer the possibility to use the space in both for generation. Somebody can choose to spend time on the rooftop terrace with a very nice view over the Cluj city, or staying at the ground under the bridge for the rainy days. But the idea it was to talk about the complementarity between the different kind of material and how with a very simple shapes, we can generate, and low cost, we can generate architecture. This is a project, a mixed-use project, on where we recover industrial area in the middle of Bucharest. Actually, it was an ex-brewery. This is the, and the name of project is Fosta Fabrica. All in this area, we have three building, industrial building that were classified like a monument, and we were forced to keep it, but it was good because this gives the identity of the project, make the difference between this project and other projects. So the monuments, I didn't talk about them today, but there we have all the function that come in the complementarity with this dwelling apartments, where we put all the dwellings together and in crossing, forcing to make a circulation between them. In the opposite part of the site, we have a preparation in, installation for beer that now we were transforming in lofts, apartments, and putting on this diagonal people that live there, they are forced and meet together in the middle where we have, as you can see in the picture, together with the ground floor of the residential building, we have the community area, food court, small restaurants, cafeteria, workshop for local artists, and trying to develop a real community that revamping, refurbish that destructured area, because now it's in the area of North Railway Station where things start to be changed, but still are in progress. This shape of the building, it's that looks like a separation, because behind of the building, all the big scale volume from the office buildings come to this area where we want to preserve it like an old part of the city. And the left side, you can see one of the monuments that will be refurbished. It was the grain storage, and now will be an office building. So, and give this opportunity for people that live there to work there. And as I told you, in the same concept of the community that you hear in the others' presentation. But the building is designed in a way to make this separation between this large scale volume that will come from the west, from the behind of the image that you see, and make the transition with the lower buildings that are in the east and especially in the south. And that's why we generate these sky lines, in idea, of course, to mitigate, negotiate between, let's say, urban appearance and immobiliar pressure. And we choose to use the same affordable and sustainable concepts, choosing a very simple and clear structure that is very correct, expressed in the image of the building, with some big size shifts and some, let's say, diamonds that special steel beams where are special apartments with their own green roofs. Yes, wait a second. This is the last what I want to tell you. This is the west part of a building that you can see. And as I told you from the beginning, it's very important our design to develop also sustainable cities. Thank you very much.
Vă mulțumesc. Vă mulțumesc foarte mult pentru prezentarea dumneavoastră. V-am întâlnit acum câțiva ani la o conferință de arhitectură de interior, GIS, la București. Iată că după 4 ani reveniți la Șer cu o prezentare foarte, foarte complexă, cu multe proiecte. Vă felicit, vă mulțumesc pentru prezența dumneavoastră. dați-mi voie să vă oferim o carte din partea companiei noastre, pe care vă oferi colega noastră, studentă la arhitectură. Este o carte care descrie care este viitorul arhitectului și arhitecturii. Vă mulțumesc încă o dată!